Hello, this is Father Finn. I want to ask you a question. What do you feed your fish? You go to the store and buy a can of flakes and put flakes in with your fish? You go to the supermarket and buy some shrimp, clams, and fish and chop it all up, kind of puree it and feed that to your fish? Is that what you do? Do you feed vegetables to your fish? Kale or spirulina algae or maybe Japanese dried algae shoots? Is that what you feed your fish? Do you hatch brine shrimp and feed the baby brine shrimp to your fish? What do you feed your fish? Well, whatever it is way more than they need. You're feeding your fish probably 10 to 20 to 30 to 40 times more than your fish actually need in order to survive. Well, it's really a function of understanding what your aquarium is. Think of it this way. Is your aquarium that much of a chain of food and water and animals that flows into it and flows out of it? In other words, are you putting food in and then filtering to take excess food and waste and so forth out? If you are, then you're compensating for overfeeding by taking out a substantial portion of the nutrition that you're putting in. And that's certainly a way to be able to maintain a tank. It's not a particularly healthy way to do it. It's not really a sustainable way. Suppose you got a hangnail on your pinky, and suppose you couldn't function because of the hangnail. You wouldn't be able to sustain your system. To the other extreme, suppose your power goes out and you have no electricity. Oh my word, what do you do then? Well, you're casting about trying to figure out what to do. What you've created is a monster that depends on all kinds of other things happening in order for it to be able to survive. That's not a desirable way to set up an aquarium. Let's take a look at this a minute. This is a 200-gallon tank that I built with my landlord. My landlord owns a glass company, and he helped me build this. We feed it a little bit of food once a day. Now, I didn't realize they were doing that. I have helpers here, and they don't always pay attention to my desires, so they keep paying attention to the fish and putting a little bit of food in there. But we have a very deep sand bed in the bottom. It's about 6 inches deep. And we have a lot of plants growing in here, and we have water flowing through it. There's a sump in the bottom with a filter bag, and that filter bag gets cleaned about once a week. So we've got some in and out going on. Not a lot, but it's some. Mostly it's all in, though. And the tank is pretty stable, and the fish are pretty happy. Well, the tank can sustain itself. Now, if I could convince my staff to not put food in it for about 6 months, they would probably freak out, panic, and say, oh no, you can't do that, they'll starve. And maybe, in fact, there would be some problems because these are big fish. And that tank really can't produce the kind of food that's needed for all these big fish. But if we have a tank with little fish in it and lots of plants growing in it, and a deep substrate, then what happens? Lots of little animals living in the sand, living down below the surface, living on the rocks, on the driftwood, on the plants, and lots of little algae also living in all those same places. They all become food for the fish living in there. Now, how long do you suppose, though, if this tank were full of 1-inch fish, how long do you suppose they would be able to survive in here if we did not put any food in at all? For how long do you think we should get away with doing that? Let's say we have 50 fish in this 200-gallon tank, and they're all about 1 inch long, and we've got lots of plants in it that are growing. How long do you suppose that could last? Well, it could last as long as you were willing to let it last. It could survive literally indefinitely with no amount of food going into that tank at all, because it would recycle. What is recycling? Part of recycling is creating, producing food for all of the different animals and plants and biological activity that's going on in there. Everything feeds on everything else. It spirals and it goes in a big circle, and it'll go down into the bottom and continue spiraling, continue feeding everything. Food will come up through the bottom with different kinds of microscopic life, little shrimp, little amoeba, little worms and so forth, algaes and whatnot, all of which will be food for the what will be the highest order of life in there. The fish will survive on that, and their waste will nurture that system. So it goes in a cycle. So it's not an in-out kind of system at all. It's everything staying in there and continuing to build this cycle in which everything is feeding off of everything else in the chain, a chain of nutrition that balances itself. And it happens very naturally. It happens kind of automatically. It's what nature really is all about. It's a system that is fundamental to the way the world works, to the way a body of water sitting out in a forest works, to the way a rain puddle that sits there month after month works. It builds upon itself. It nurtures in a chain. It goes up to the highest order animal and then back to the lowest order and continues cycling. How long? Well, until certain elements are used up. How are they used up? If when a fish dies, it stays in there, it's not taken out and removed, but is pushed down in the sand or allowed to be eaten by the other fish. If nothing comes out, then everything that's in there stays in there. So in point of fact, the only thing that runs out is what you take out. I mean, water evaporates. If you have it well covered, that'll be very, very slow. But it does. My 20-year-old tank has a pretty good cover. I have to add water to it, an inch of water about every 6 months. That's maybe 2 or 3 gallons of water every 6 months. Now, I put water in it that has nutrients, that has minerals. I don't do straight RO water because I'm still apprehensive about what it's losing. So I'm adding minerals back, and they're feeding in the chain. So think of your aquarium not as something you throw something into and pull something out of, but as a balanced environment, which has life living and thriving and moving, living and dying and being born again in other aspects of the life cycle. That's what the father fish system is all about. Will it last 100 years? I don't know. I haven't been around that long. Will it last 20 years? I guarantee it. I've got tanks 10 years old and they're going strong. Will it last 50 years? I don't know. But here's what I guarantee you. If you do this as a child and you're able to keep that tank going, it will still be there when you're as old as I am. I wish I had some of the tanks that I set up when I was little. Try to do something small that you can carry with you through your life. Take it with you wherever you go. Don't break it down. Keep it going. And keep it going, and keep it going. Let's see how long these forever tanks can last. There's a challenge for you. Take it on. I'll see you soon. This is Father Dave talking about a living environment. Bye for now.